Many throughout history have underestimated the Green. In this way, Brainiac was no different than Superman or Batman. They all thought they could improve upon nature. They all were wrong. Earth belonged to the Green for eons before animals evolved. Now, the trees and plants will remind these animals upon whose planet they reside. When the next crisis comes, nature will protect itself. I stand with the Green, and the Green alone.
Brainiac thought he had me all figured out. Said my humanity made me weak. But fighting for humanity gave me the strength to body that punk-ass Kolluin. And before he dropped, I took a few things. His 12th level intellect and his ship's data core. I thought the internet was gigantic. But now, I've got the whole wide universe at my fingertips. First up, I put back every Earth city Brainiac stole, starting with my hometown, the Motor City. Then I keep going. Superman wants to secure one world, but I can reboot tens of thousands. Every last one in Brainiac's collection. Gonna be a long trip, but another benefit of my new 12th level intellect is I can reunite with some old friends. Titans together. Booyah.
With 9 lives, it had to happen sooner or later. I got everything I ever wanted, including a handsome prince and a badass reputation as the woman who beat Brainiac. And I must say, I was bored to death. Bruce and I worked better when we were forbidden, when the masks were on and the claws were out. That honeymoon was over. So I did the best thing for both of us. I'm not sad. I didn't become Catwoman to bag Bruce Wayne. I don't ever want to rely on anyone but myself. I'll go where I want to go, take what I want to take. And never, ever look back.
So much for heroes. Brainiac had barely hit the floor when the arguing started. Should we kill him? Keep him alive? I couldn't watch them go to war. Not again. So I ran. Into the Speed Force. Brainiac wanted the universe to himself, so I dropped him off at the end of history. But I still kept running. I needed to be alone. Then I heard a familiar voice. It was Jay and the other speedsters. A crisis is coming, he told me. But if we run fast enough, together, we just might save the multiverse. I thought I'd been running away, but I was running towards something. It's good to believe in heroes again.
The Guardians ordered me to bring Brainiac to Oa to stand trial. I was plenty happy to put a few thousand light years between that alien and Earth. After the trial, the Guardians dropped a bombshell on me. Sinestro was free, busted out of their science cells. A frontal assault on the Sinestro Corps was a no-go. Us Greens were still weak from fighting Superman's regime. That's why I volunteered to go undercover as a Yellow Lantern. Pass. I need to re-embrace my fear. But fear's an addiction. Once I've picked up that bottle, it's gonna be awfully hard putting it back down again. I just hope I have the will to see it through.
I still can't believe it! Me, bringing down Brainiac! Who knew? Still, Bat surprised me, offering me a spot in the Justice League. Not totally sure he ain't crazy, but who says no to that guy? You know, Being good feels good. But every now and again, every once in a while, I get this irresistible urge to go out and bash some heads! Hopefully being good will stick long term. Till I'm sure my kid Lucy's still gonna know me as her crazy Aunt Holleen. Maybe someday I can give her the real scoop.
Brainiac's attack left the world devastated. Thousands dead. Many more thousands homeless. When President Kane asked that I head up the emergency response, I couldn't refuse. The job's demands require that I leave the Justice League in Barry's and Hal's hands. Together, they're molding the younger heroes into a force for good, unlike any Earth has ever seen. But I'm only semi-retired. Behind the scenes, I've been preparing for Superman's return. Cal swore he'd escape from the Phantom Zone. I'd be foolish not to take him at his word.
I vowed to protect the Earth. But to guarantee its safety, I need to expand my vision. Brainiac's ship is the ultimate weapon. But in my hands, it can be so much more. Millions of civilizations await rebirth in Brainiac's collection. I'll find the bravest and strongest warriors among them, and I'll start a new regime. No, a new legion. The Legion of Superheroes. With it, I'll bring peace not just to Earth, to the entire universe and the universes that lie beyond.
I hadn't begun my day thinking I'd give a wannabe alien overlord a haircut. That was a happy accident. But what I first thought a distraction inspired my life's greatest work. I found Brainiac's collection. Those poor cities from across the universe, trapped aboard his ship. There was only one thing to do. I restored them and gave Earth the reboot it so desperately needed. I stitched together a crazy quilt of alien civilizations without regard to rhyme or reason. Afraid, confused, devolved to their basest instincts. They kill each other in the most sickening ways. And I get to sit back, munch popcorn, and enjoy the show, watching as the world burns.
My punishment of Brainiac's crimes had unintended consequences. His death disabled his ship. Billions of collected souls perished. I did not know they could be restored. Their deaths unleashed such rage. My Red Lanterns were overwhelmed. They drove me from Ismalt. They would have killed me if not for Proselyte. The emotional entity offered me compassion, not rage. In the face of my grave error, I now understand the emotional spectrum requires balance. My Red Lantern's rage must punish the worst offenders, but it cannot blindly consume those who deserve compassion. Befuddled look, frozen on Brainiac's dead face, is a vision I will always relish. Even as I ripped the head from his body, the alien couldn't believe that an ape was taking his life. I quickly mastered Brainiac's technology, exponentially increasing my telepathic power. Then I enslaved Earth's humans, finally relegating them to their proper place. But my victory over those vermin was only the beginning. Now, fully in command of Brainiac's vast powers, I am the greatest conqueror the universe has ever seen. All worlds will kneel before Emperor Grodd.
Hungry for his blood, I prepared to claim Brainiac. But the alien, desperate to save his life, sputtered out an offer. Brainiac said that if I spared him, he'd deposit any of his collected beings I wanted on a world of my choosing. There, I could pursue them at my leisure. So now I hunt, free from Wonder Woman's interference. With each kill, I glorify the goddess. As for Brainiac, of course, I didn't abide our agreement. I'd never given up on killing him. A true huntress always catches her prey.
Grodd used the damn nano explosive in my head to make me his bitch. The jobs he made me do. Let's just say they crossed some lines. I bet taking Brainiac and Grodd into the authorities would be doing another stretch in Bell Rev. And I was right. Bruce Wayne even bankrolled getting rid of my TNT migraines for good. I freaking hate hospitals, but God, was it worth it. With that nano safely out, I could finally see Zoe again. Last time I saw my little girl, she had 9 candles on her birthday cake. Now I got a second shot at being dad. I sure as hell don't plan to miss it.
My hands still shake when I remember Brainiac's collection of Krypton. I want to give the world he stole a second chance, but bonding with Brainiac's ship is too risky. I need a safer way to restore our cities. I'm so glad for the Justice League's help. Barry, Professor Stein, they've already taught me so much. Every day, we get closer to reversing Brainiac's collection process. When we do, we'll pick the right star system. What Brainiac ruined will be reborn. Argo City in Kandor, Twin Cities. Survivors. I couldn't save Kal-El, but I will save our people.